Philosophers spend their days toying with thought puzzles on the meaning of life and whether shadows on the cave wall depict reality. Today, there is a different kind of philosophy, one that could determine whether you live or die. It's called the trolley problem. It goes something like this. You're enjoying an afternoon stroll near the train tracks when you see five people tied down to a track with a trolley barreling toward them. You realize you're right next to a lever that will send the trolley to another track. But on that second line, one person is tied down. Do you pull the lever, changing the trolley's natural course, sacrificing one life to save five? The problem has created all sorts of popular philosophical what-ifs. But with the advent of self-driving cars, these mind games quickly become serious policy questions. Self-driving cars use a combination of sensors and software to do all the driving for us. They're programmed to follow traffic rules and navigate obstacles. Some scientists, though, envision these cars ultimately becoming connected, meaning they're able to communicate with things like traffic lights and other cars. And this means they're going to start making choices. Or more accurately, programmers, lawmakers, consumers, they're going to be programming in their choices. A few examples. Imagine your self-driving car is zooming down the highway when a car comes rushing toward it with five people inside. Your car can lurch off the road and save the other car's occupants, but will it have to sacrifice a pedestrian? Or maybe your car? Or maybe you? Do your priorities change if the other car is self-driven or human-driven? How about if someone's driving drunk? Do the passengers' identities matter? If it's a child, a terminally ill patient, a head of state, the Dalai Lama? What if the other car's worth a lot of money? Many hope self-driving cars will reduce traffic deaths in the end. Over 40,000 people died in the U.S. in car crashes in 2017 alone. In a world of self-directed cars, driving deaths might be fewer, resulting from imperfect philosophical solutions. Meanwhile, other forms of AI will be facing the same life and death dilemmas. Think of things like fully autonomous military drones, self-flying planes, self-operating floodgates, all run by algorithms written by humans. So we know technology is progressing quickly, but its future, and all of ours, may rest on ancient principles, suddenly making those Socratic debates awfully relevant.